What are your core values? What about you adds flavor? What about you adds spice? In this episode, we are going to discuss how to understand your ingredients. Welcome to the Abundance Hack Show, Season 4, where we are focusing on mastery. The last three seasons, I gave you the information. Now, we're focusing on integrating it into our lives and embodying it. If you are ready to master your thoughts, emotions, and patterns to feel whole, fulfilled, and really grounded in who you are without dimming your shine so you can live the abundant life that you truly desire, then you are in the right place. Hey, M&Ms, thank you for tuning in to the Abundance Hack Show. What are you manifesting in your life today? This episode is going to be a little quirky. So last week I went on a rant. Thank you so much if you listened to my rant. Sometimes you just have to get things off your chest. But one of the things that I mentioned last week is someone said to me that I'm the most judgmental person in the world. And I had to really sit with that, and it's something that I'm aware of, and it's something I work through, not being judgmental. And I actually talked to a friend about this, and they said, I don't think you're judgmental. I think you have opinions about people not living to their full potential and people not being the highest version of themselves, but I don't think that that's judgmental, but I think it's semantics. Some people may feel like if I look at someone and I'm like, well, I think this person is settling because they're capable of so much more, people can view that as judgment. So semantics, and you know, there's a light and shadow side of everything, yin and yang, right? So how I like to break this down in my brain is ingredients. We all have ingredients that make us who we are. Just like if you're cooking a meal or baking a cake or pie, whatever tickles your fancy, you have ingredients, and you have some ingredients that are the core ingredients that make it whatever it is. And then you have some things that add flavor and add spice and make it really yummy. Then you have stuff that makes it healthy. Then you have fillers that add to it, but may not be as healthy. So that's kind of how I see us. We have things that make up who we are, and too much of anything can be bad, right? So you add sugar to make things sweet, but too much sugar is bad. You add salt to add flavor, but too much salt is bad. I love cheese, but too much cheese is bad. You know, like, especially if you're lactose intolerant, then maybe you don't want cheese at all. And it's the same thing with us. Like, there are going to be some people that just don't resonate with us, with who we are, and that is okay. And think about stuff like gluten. You know, gluten is in so many products. Like, if you love bread and chips and things like that, then gluten is an ingredient that's an issue for a lot of people. And it's the same thing with us. Like, I am someone who is very opinionated, and that is an issue for some people. And me being opinionated, that actually speaks to me being considered judgmental. But me being opinionated is something that I've actually tried to hide about myself for so long. And when I started doing my deep inner work and my parts work, or like fragmentation, if you haven't listened to the fragmentation episode, definitely go check it out. It is a game changer. And when I started really identifying and integrating all of my different parts, I realized that me being opinionated and outspoken and having these strong opinions about things was something that I hid from the world because I thought it made me unlovable. I'm from New York. I was raised by a strong Black woman, and I think that there was some fear that if I speak out about certain things and I share my strong opinions, that people could view me as an angry Black woman. And so I started hiding my opinions and not speaking my truth. So I was more relatable and digestible and acceptable. And in the process of doing that, I was not being loyal to myself. And so as I started voicing my opinion and sharing how I feel about things and really activating that throat chakra, sharing my needs and desires and communicating with people when I have healthy boundaries or I have needs or desires, a lot of people weren't, I don't want to say a lot of people, but some people in my life were not okay with that. And what I did in the past, because I wanted to hold on to people, is I apologized for how I felt. I apologized for my truth. And obviously, just like I said with the sugar and the salt, like we use sugar and salt in our food, too much sugar, too much salt is a bad thing. So there is a balance of not giving unsolicited feedback. So I do catch myself when I am giving my opinion about something and it wasn't a space for it. So obviously I have learned balance through that inner work and that inner healing. But one thing I will say is I will not apologize for my truth. I will not apologize for my truth. And that is something that I had to really, really work on to ground into my confidence and my courage and like who I am and having that courage to speak my truth and be unapologetic about it. It's a work in progress, still working on it. And obviously this podcast has definitely helped me become more confident and comfortable sharing my truth. So I want you to think about something. I want you to think about something. Have you ever thought about the light side of your shadow? Because I just said we have a yin and yang, we have a light and dark side. But have you ever thought about the light side of your shadow? Because I believe that everything about us has a light side. Now, we focus on the shadow side of, you know, our light. And that's why we do the shadow work. But what if we reversed it and we identified our shadow and tried to identify the light in that shadow? So think about it. What if your shadow can be directed or channeled towards your superpower? Because if you take my situation, for example, like me being opinionated and me, and judgmental is obviously someone's perception of that. But the fact that I have these opinions is part of why I started a podcast, to share my opinions and to create a safe space for others to share their opinions and their stories. So what if the part of you that you thought was unlovable is actually your superpower? I really want you to think about this. So what if we can direct our shadows and channel it towards our superpower? Or is your shadow actually your superpower? And I think that society tries to keep us in a box and it tries to control us and it tells us how we have to be and how we have to act and how we have to dress and how we have to feel. But when you start to break out of that and you're like, okay, I'm gonna feel how I feel. I don't care what society says and I don't care how society says my life should look and how I should be and how I should act and who I should love. Like when you really start to get to the core of who you are and understand yourself and get intimate and honest with yourself, you start breaking away from all of the programming. And the more that I do that, the more that I see how much I've been molded by society and by programming that made me feel like these things about myself are unlovable, that actually contributes to who I am and the amazing life that I have, the businesses that I've started, this podcast, my studios. Like, if I didn't want people to be the best version of themselves, I would have never started my dance and aerial studio, the lives that I've changed with that studio. And I wouldn't have started Bliss Bar Meditation Studio, the lives that I've changed with Bliss Bar Meditation Studio, helping people be the best version of themselves. So while the person who isn't ready to be the best version of themselves are like, you're so judgmental, blah, 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 the next person who is ready to do the work is like, oh my God, tell me what you see. Tell me, you know, like the highest version of myself. Help me step into the next phase in my life and expand to allow more abundance in. So everything is perspective. And I think that we like to point out people's shadows and their true colors. I've been seeing memes that says like, you do one bad thing and a person is like, oh, you're showing your true colors. So it's like people are looking for that shadow. So what I want you to do is reverse that shit and look for the light in your shadow. Whoo, you guys. And it's so funny to me. It's funny because we have half of the population that think that they're better than what they actually are because they're not being real with themselves. They're not like, they're disassociated, you know, and they don't want to face their reality. They don't want to face the fact that they may have dropped the ball. They don't want to face the guilt or shame. And then you have the other half of the population that's way more capable than what they give themselves credit for. And they have way more value that they don't even see. So it's so funny how we have like one end of the spectrum and then the opposite end of the spectrum. So what I'm trying to do is inspire people to really get to know themselves, the good, the bad, and the ugly, because the bad is usually just some trauma that we need to heal and send ourselves love, compassion, and acceptance for. And then the ugly is usually society's programming, trying to get us to fit into a box and tell us these things about us make us unlovable. So what I invite you to do is get really, really clear on your good, bad, and ugly. And usually when you name a thing, it takes its power away. So if you don't want to look in the back of the closet, you don't want to see the skeletons in the back of the closet, you don't want to see what was swept under the rug, then it has power, because if someone says something or does something that triggers you, you haven't been willing to look in the closet or under the rug. But if you're willing to go in that closet and clean out those skeletons and sweep away the stuff that's been swept under the rug, it takes its power away. It takes its power away, which is why when I was told that I was the most judgmental person in the world, you know, obviously it's a thing because I'm talking about it, but I'm talking about it because I've done the work to like really look at how I show up and my inner thoughts and my inner thought patterns. And so when you name a thing, it takes its power away. And so one of the things that I had to, when I was sitting with this, I'm like, you know, I do have opinions about people and their lives and settling and being the best version of yourself and having courage and really activating that solar plexus chakra to have the courage to go after the life and the love that you truly desire. I do have opinions about it. And it does make me sad when people settle. And it does make me sad when people are not going after the life that they're capable of. And because of that, I start businesses to support people in doing that. And the reality is, if people are not ready, they're gonna view it as I'm judging them. And I have to be okay with that. You know, I've had to make peace with that. And so making peace with the ugly, basically, because there is light in that ugly. There is light in that shadow. So that's what I'm inviting you to do, is identify the good, the bad, and the ugly, and find the light in that ugly. Find the healing in that bad. So to do this work, to really get honest with yourself about your good, bad, and ugly, it takes courage. It takes raw honesty. It takes self-awareness and it takes emotional stability. Like, this is deep inner work that a lot of people avoid. And it's understandable because sometimes we don't want to look at the stuff that causes us pain, or we don't want to look at our toxic patterns. We don't want to look at the things that we feel make us unlovable, but doing this work will change your life. And one thing my therapist says is all parts are welcome. And when she said that to me a few weeks ago, I actually wrote it down because I was like, ooh, we can get into a pattern of self-judgment and self-criticism. Like, you know, I could feel bad that some people consider me judgmental. And usually when we're triggered, or when someone says something and we feel bad about it, it's because we have some type of internal shame or guilt. And so when my therapist said that all parts are welcome, that's what I'm saying about like the bad part. Like, usually is something we need to heal, or is something society has told us that is unlovable. So if we start having self-acceptance, that is the game changer. Accepting your good, bad, and ugly. So this is not about feeling like, oh, I'm broken because I have these bad parts or these ugly parts. This is about unconditional self-acceptance, sending yourself love, compassion, and acceptance for all of your parts. So I invite you to journal on this, to understand the good, the bad, and the ugly, and try to find perspective on the bad. What do you need to heal? And then try to find perspective, a different perspective. So not a criticizing perspective, but try to find a positive light perspective on the ugly. How has people in my life or society made me feel this is unacceptable? And where or how can this thing be appreciated? So finding that perspective, or finding where you need to heal, and actually doing the inner work to heal the thing, or finding the beauty in the thing that people made you feel is unlovable. Like, let's take Wendy Williams, for example. Wendy Williams was always bashed for gossiping, but then she started a talk show and people freaking loved it. So while I don't necessarily condone gossiping, but that was something people could consider a shadow side of her that actually was one of her superpowers. Her talk show, I mean, it was a bunch of like celebrity news, essentially gossip, but like her shadow was her superpower. So I invite you to journal on this. Could your shadow be your superpower? But you just have to shift your perspective or zoom out a little bit and pull away from the programming and the societal norms to be able to truly see your power. So I invite you to journal on what your superpower is. And this is not a time to be modest. This is not a time to be modest. There's gonna be plenty of times in life where you have to be modest. This is not that time. I want you to really own it. Really celebrate your talents, your gifts, your little unique things about you that make you special. Like, really own it. Like, let's normalize grounded confidence. Let's normalize celebrating ourselves and our gifts. Let's normalize owning our gifts, our skills, our talents, and being unapologetic about it. And I understand there's a lot of programming that says don't brag, don't boast, don't come across as conceited or cocky, but that is programming that I feel got distorted at some point, because it causes people, especially women, to feel like what's socially acceptable is to act insecure. So I feel there is nothing humble about acting insecure. And if you think about it, like, if you give, I want to say if you give women, but I'm sure that there's men that do this too, but I feel like it's more prominent in women. If you give women a compliment, they find a way to talk down about themselves or the thing, because it's programmed in us that that comes across as more humble. So like if you say, oh, I like your hair, she'll say, oh, it's so frizzy today. Or, oh, I like your dress. And she'll say, oh, this old thing? Oh, you did great with the presentation. Oh, I messed up on my words. I'm like, honey, accept the compliments and don't talk down on yourself. Like, there's nothing humble in doing that. There's not. And I think that somewhere along the lines, the whole like be humble thing got distorted, and women are not able to receive compliments and receive praise. There's nothing wrong with receiving praise, and we need to get in the habit of praising ourselves. Own your light, like ground in your confidence. Whew, I'm getting worked up, you guys. Okay, so get to know your ingredients. Get to know your superpowers and start to give yourself compliments daily and watch how things shift for you. I started owning one of my superpowers, which is making everything magical, because I do. And when I started owning that, then people started saying to me like, oh my God, your energy, you make everything so magical. You know, people send me unicorns and stuff like that. And I say, thank you, because I know this is one of my superpowers. And then also in my head, I'm like, I know, right? Yep, that's my superpower. But it's okay to own that. And that's not being conceited. That's not being cocky. So to me, cocky or conceited would be me thinking that I'm better than the next person. And it's not about the next person, because it's not about comparison. It's about me adding magic to the world. And me adding magic to the world doesn't take away from the next person adding magic to the world. Because I'm like, please join me in adding magic to the world. And we can just live in a magical ass world. Like, yes, please. I am here for it. You know? So it's like, own it. Own it. I make things magical. I do. And there's nothing wrong with me saying that. So what I want is for people to own their magic, own their gifts, own their talents and their skills, own it, ground in what you bring to this world, ground in your value, own your value and know your worth. That is my message. That is my message. So I invite you to sit with this and get out your journal, take some notes, you know? And I really hope this episode inspires you to get clear on your ingredients, your superpowers, and your value, so you can ground in them and own it. And if you know someone that needs to hear this, please share this episode with them. And I also want to know how this lands with you. I love hearing your feedback. You can always reach out to me on Instagram. I'm the most active on Instagram at Niajae, N-I-A-J-A-E. And until next time, own your worth. And be decadent. Thank you for tuning in to the Abundance Hack Show. I would love to hear from you. Leave your comments and questions, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any of our yummy episodes. Every time you leave a 5-star rating or review, I do my happy dance.